When you open up a discussion, first make sure you take a look closely at the assignment instructions, and then take a look at the rubric to see how it is that you will be evaluated for your work in that discussion. Additionally, you'll see these buttons up at the top where you can collapse all the replies or you can expand them. As soon as you have hovered over an item, it will mark it as unread. And as we scroll down, you'll see that if I stay over that discussion, it's going to turn that blue dot into a gray dot. So it's going to mark it as read as soon as you've scrolled over it. The other thing that I really want to highlight are the pages. It's quite apparent that most people typically read those posts on that first page. And if you're required to reply to two people, as this discussion forum had, please make sure that you're looking at it through those other pages. A lot of times the students on pages 2 and 3 that have posted later, nobody ever replies to them. They don't go to those pages. Do make sure that you're looking over all of the posts and that you're reading them and choosing selectively who you want to reply to. Now, when you are writing a reply, for instance, if I'm writing a reply here, one of the things that a lot of you marked on this skills survey was not sure how to insert hyperlinks into a rich content editor. A rich content editor is basically anytime you see this WYSIWYG editor up at the top. And basically, if you have a hyperlink, as soon as you have typed a reply, if you wanted to include a hyperlink, say to an external website, you would just highlight that word, click on the link button, and then you can plug in the URL. And it will turn it into a hyperlink. So then when I post this response, and I click on this hyperlink, I'm going to go out to Google. So that's how you would use a hyperlink. The other thing that people have asked about is how to include additional like multimedia material within a reply. And it's pretty easy. You can use the built-in system within Canvas where you would simply click on the media comment button. You'll have to allow flash on your computer, and then you can start recording. Post a reply in a recording, hit stop. You can listen to your, it's going to buffer.
Post a reply in a recording.
And then save it. The other option you have if you don't want to do a webcam recording would just be to record audio. And so if you wanted to record yourself speaking, you can simply record yourself speaking, save, and then post it that way. If you want to use a podcast and you want to create your own audio or video external to Canvas, you can actually upload those files once you have found, say, the file or the video file. You can upload those items directly and post those. So that's how you use the rich content editor for inserting hyperlinks or inserting media. And take a look, you can scroll through, and if you hover over any of these, it's going to tell you what the item is. So here's an image embed, if you were going to insert a math equation for some reason, but that's what the rich content editor will allow you to do.